when people say, where are you from? I always joke now, I always say the middle of a cornfield. And I think they think that I'm not telling the truth or I'm exaggerating, but I really am from the middle of a cornfield. There was lots to do. You just had to think of it, right? Oh my gosh. I must have spent so many teenage nights rolling, and don't jump to conclusions, rolling in my hometown was TPing. I had my own way of getting the toilet paper way, way up in the trees. So I was a baton twirler, a majorette in high school, and I learned to pop the end off, the rubber end off the baton, and put the toilet paper down on it. And if you flicked it, oh my gosh, it went really far. So I grew up as the minister's kid, and my dad was very strict. We weren't allowed to say the word darn. But he would allow us to go TPing to get people back. Good morning, sunshine, on a Tuesday. I've hosted the morning show for 11 years now. 11 years. I'm not going to lie. I wear earplugs. And I take melatonin. I have a sound machine, you know, a white noise machine. And I plug in, like, the HEPA filter, because that's really loud. I put my iPhone right by my head, and it's off. So if a newsroom calls and it's before the alarm goes off, I don't tell you.
More than 600,000 people just spent a bitterly cold night in storm-damaged houses without power.
Not every day can be the same, and you can't always be chipper happy because, you know, sometimes the news is pretty awful. Now, on a regular basis, I think human dynamic changes like every 2 minutes, right? Think about this. Even at a funeral, you're sad, but then you sit around and you go, wonder what's for lunch. I think that's just so human. I know that while the news may not be good, it is my job to send you out the door feeling like you can take on the day. Otherwise, if you don't frame things right in the morning, I'm liable to make somebody go right back to bed and go, oh, screw it. We keep the mood up. First of all, in the commercials, what you don't hear at home is we jam to a lot of different music. If you're going to do lighting for our show, you are required to also do music. And I mean, you've got to be on it. You got to be on the music when that commercial ends, because it's only 2 minutes. So, yeah, it's become the de facto job of the lighting director. I do wish we had a show. This would be a great reality show of just what happens in the brains. It's almost like you joke, oh, there's an HR kiosk right in front of our... in front of our set, because we're just so out with everything with each other, because we all worked with each other for so long. For example, Bob will tell me, oh, some twisted joke, and then he'll be sure, because he's worked with me long enough to know, to tell me, now don't use that word on the air. My husband has told him, you know, if you tell Robin a joke or you use some word that she shouldn't be using on the air, make sure you tell her. Because she, you know, grew up as a preacher's kid, she may not know that this is dirty. So Bob will say, don't use this term on the air. And I'll be like, thank you.